Hello students, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to give you 5 latest defense updates. Number 1, unveiling indigenous unmanned surface vessel Vega. Larsen & Toubro, a prominent Indian private sector conglomerate, showcased its indigenously developed unmanned surface vessel named Vega to the Defense Secretary Shri Giridhar Armani. The unveiling took place at L&T's state-of-the-art shipyard in Kuttupalli, where the Defense Secretary witnessed a demonstration of the USV's capabilities. The Vega USV boasts a unique operational flexibility, functioning in fully autonomous, semi-autonomous and remote-controlled modes. This versatility allows the system to be interfaced with existing vessels, effectively transforming them into unmanned platforms. Next, DRDO seeks manufacturers for advanced humanoid upper body robotics. DRDO has taken a step towards acquiring next generation robotic capabilities. The organization has issued tenders for the manufacturing, integration, testing and supply of humanoid body robotic system. Next, unpacking the reality of Lockheed Martin's F-21 fighter jet. Lockheed Martin F-21 fighter jet has been making headlines as the American contender in India's medium role fighter aircraft MRFA deal, positioning itself as a formidable option for the Indian Air Force. However, beneath the flashy marketing and bold claims lies a more nuanced reality that deserves closer scrutiny. Next, steel bullets and hit-and-run tactics pose new challenge for Indian Army. Indian Army intelligence sources have expressed concern over a worrying trend in recent militant attacks in Kashmir. These attacks, characterized by the use of steel core bullets and well-coordinated hit-and-run tactics, have resulted in casualty among Indian security forces. Military sources claim the insurgents are deploying steel-coated bullets designed to penetrate the armor of military vehicles. Next, unveiling guidelines for authorizing space activities in India. The InSpace has taken InSpace, the full form of InSpace is the Indian National Space Promotion and Authorization Center, has taken a major step toward in implementing the Indian Space Policy 2023 on May 3rd. They released a detailed 147-page document outlining the authorization process for various space activities. This marks a significant development for India's space sector as it opens doors for broader participation from both government and non-government entities. Thank you.